Welcome back to Inside City Hall. We are turning our attention back to the crowded race for public advocate. And tonight, here on New York One, another candidate is officially launching her bid for that position. Brooklyn Assemblywoman Latrice Walker joins us to tell us more. You are a candidate for public advocate as of today.
I am. And thank you so much for having me this evening, Earl.
Okay, tell me what this is all about. What makes you want to run for this job?
Well, I live on the same block that I was born and raised on. I grew up in NYCHA in public housing. And I remember when NYCHA came to my mom and told her that she would have to move out of her apartment, sign a document maybe this high, and they would have the right to return. And they told that to all 465 residents of public housing in Prospect Plaza. And people left, and they never did get that opportunity to return back home. And my mom said to me that she wanted me to go to law school to prevent that from ever happening again to anyone in the city of New York. And I did just that. I worked as counsel to Congresswoman Yvette Clark. I've defended numerous residents for evictions throughout the city. I've also defended people who was before the jurisdiction of the criminal justice system. This office, I think, is about advocating as much as it is about agitating, litigating, and legislating. Mm. And I have done all four of those things in my career.
Okay, well, so when you look at the various powers and opportunities and so forth, would you add anything to what the public advocate currently has under its roof? Would you make any changes to the office?
Absolutely, Errol. We know that there are people who are trying to eliminate this office, but this is a critical office, and actually what I would like to do is to add subpoena powers to the office, add investigatory powers to the office, and also give it the ability to sue in its own right. The question of standing has always been an issue for the office, and we need to go in and change that. In addition to that, the office should not just have a tiebreaker vote in a New York City Council. I think it should have a vote as well.
Okay, very interesting. You sound a lot when you talk about these expanded powers, like a certain public advocate who currently holds the position, Letitia James, your friend. Yes. And I noticed on the night that she won and became Attorney General-elect that you were standing right beside her, and I believe introduced her, if I'm not mistaken.
Yes.
It was a complicated night, but you're right there with her. Is she supporting this effort?
Well, let me say I'm very proud of Letitia James. She was the first African-American woman to be elected citywide. She's the first African-American woman to be elected statewide. And I am proud to be one of her biggest fans and one of her proudest supporters. Mm-hmm. Just like Letitia James, she is one vote in New York City, and I will have to fight to defend and receive her support, mm-hmm. just like I have to get the support of voters all across the city of New York. And that is something I know a lot about. Running for assembly in a very crowded field where I wasn't necessarily supported by the establishment. I had to do it again when I needed to come back and defend my seat. And now here I am, humbly submitting myself to allow me to provide justice, fairness, and equity to the office, just as my predecessor, Letitia James, have done.
We are trying to keep a count on how many people are actually seeking this office. By my count, I think we're up to at least a couple of dozen. And that's before you and Melissa Mark Viverito declared today. You've been around the block a few times, electorally speaking. You've been in some crowded races, but probably not quite this crowded. Mm. How do you get from here to there in a race with, you know, at least 20 other people seeking the same job?
Well, Errol, I'm a single mom. And I am going to communicate all across this city that I want a quality education for my daughter, quality health care, not just for my daughter, but for children all across the city of New York, access to health care for seniors, and the ability to be able to afford to live in a city that people grew up in and they want to stay in. They need to enjoy that prosperity. I've been told that this may not be my time. This may not be the right time. But I am saying on behalf of everyone who have been told that they needed to wait, mm-hmm. on behalf of all women who told that we needed to stay on the sidelines, that it's our time. It's time for us to get off, and I am here, and I'm running, and I'm appealing to all New Yorkers to support me for New York City Public Advocate.
Okay, look, I know you from Central Brooklyn politics. Have you any experience in campaigning or otherwise dealing with public policy issues outside of Central Brooklyn?
Well, absolutely. One of the things that we know with bail reform, let's say some of the legislation I was able to introduce. Bail reform is something that we know so many people are sitting on Rikers Island right now. They haven't been convicted of any crime, but based on poverty, they are still behind bars. I introduced a bail reform piece of legislation, which was passed overwhelmingly in the New York State Assembly, and we had to gain a lot of coalitions to be able to do that. And in addition to that, Raise the Age is something I'm very proud of. And we know that a part of Raise the Age, the mayor has to move 16 to 17-year-olds off of Rikers Island. And one of the things that he wanted to be able to do was to take those young people and put them into a juvenile detention facility called Ella McQueen. I took on the mayor through the leadership of myself and many members of my community. We fought back and we won. In addition to that, right across the street from the 73rd precinct is another juvenile detention facility where the mayor wanted to build a youth court. Well, we took him on again in that situation and we won. And any time that I see that there's an injustice or something inhumane done to any community from Brownsville to the Upper West Side, we're going to take on the mayor and we're going to win.
Okay, we will see you out on the campaign trail. We will wish you the best of luck. Please keep in touch with us, and we'll see how all of this works out.
Thank you.
Okay, Latrice Walker, candidate for public advocate. We're going to take a short